Students, today we will read about why do we fall ill or health and diseases. Okay. So the chapter name is our chapter. So today we'll discuss about why do we fall ill or health and diseases. Now health and its failure, infectious, non-infectious diseases, their causes, manifestation, disease caused by microbes like virus, bacteria and several other pathogens, principle of treatment, their prevention and vaccination program. So all these are the contents of this topic. So let's come to that. What is the health and disease called? So living body is interconnected, integrated whole, where no single structure or function is independent of other structure and function. So in our body, if you take our body, then our body consists of lots of organ, then tissue and cells. So these are infected. Now what is the infection means? Some pathogen attacks our body. So this is created by some pathogen. These pathogen cause harm to this system of living, that is a living system. So the infections of. An infection means more than we are going to. We are called diseased. Now this is disease. Two parts are there. This means this is disturbed easiness. So this is disturbed easiness. So a person is diseased. That means his or her easiness is disturbed, and that normally infection or many other reasons are also there. Not only infection, some other reasons are also there for this having the disease. So person cannot be said as healthy when the person is having disease. So the next term is health. Now what is health? Health always does not mean that the person should be disease free. So health and disease free is different thing. Health person should be mentally well, physically also well, and psychologically also well. Mental, psychological, you can say emotional. So these factors, when person is healthy, means all such kind of factors are good. Mentally also good, socially also good, and what you say physically and psychologically also good, emotionally also good. So health is affected by mental, emotional factors, physical factors, as well as social factors. So a person can said to be healthy or being well if the person is not suffering from any infection, that is absence of any infection. So when we say as healthy, when there is absence of infection, right? Absence of any physical deformity, no physical problems are there, physical deformity, absence of any hereditary disease. So person should not receive any hereditary disease from their parents, and persons should take, like there should not be any absence of this diet and nutrition. So this is absence of diet or nutrition should not be there, right? Absence of any mental problems, absence of mental problems. So I'm discussing a person can said to be healthy or being well when, what are the conditions? When the person is devoid of infection, when the person is devoid of physical deformity, when the person is devoid of hereditary disease, when the person is devoid of he should not suffer from absence of diet or nutrition, and also he must be devoid of any mental problems, then freedom for anxiety, okay? So social tensions, so then persons should not have any anxiety, freedom from anxiety or with a tension. So if these factors are not there with the person, then the person is can be said as healthy. So World Health Organization, so according to your WHO, World Health Organization, World Health Organization defined health is a state of complete physical, mental and social well-being, not merely the absence of disease or infirmity, that enables one to lead a socially and economically productive life. Okay, so who described, World Health Organization described the health as a complete physical, mental and social well-being, right? That's the definition of health as per World Health Organization. Now what are the immediate health problems? Like we are having the living system, so what are the health problems may occur to us? Physical injuries may happen, disrupted food, water, things can happen. We may that may cause hunger, thirst, weakness can happen. Like even there is always a shortage of blood, medicine, shelter, clothing, all these things may happen. We like victims may be trauma suffering, mental trauma may disturb the person. Property, profession, okay, studies, this increases also health problem, means tensions, anxiety, this also helps the may cause the different kinds of disease also. Like if suppose mental trauma persists for long time, and some chronic kind of diseases also may occur, like significant health problems. These are diseases like which we receive when we are in overcrowding position, cold, cough, pneumonia, tuberculosis, such kind of diseases may happen. Okay, and the disease can transmitted from vectors, through vectors. Vector is what? Carrier of the disease germ. So these vectors, if it is more in our society, then we may be disturbed and we can have the disease. So significance of health, then what is the significance of health? Q, what is the need of being healthy? The significance of health, like we can do any type of work nicely, okay, if your body is healthy. So good health means what? A healthy body with healthy and healthy mind and healthy attitude. So what is about good health? It's given healthy mind and healthy attitude. A person must have such kind of thing, characteristics. Good health increases our efficiency for doing work. So we are efficient to do work. We will not be tired very soon. And increased efficiency means increased, you know, a person can easily progress, and the progress of the community will happen, nation will happen. And it also, good health means happy and cheerful. This is very, very important. Happy and cheerful. It allows a person to have the initiative for betterment, joyful experience. Okay? And good health, that means healthy person give proper attention to others in the family also. So this person can take care family. He is on earth, that does not matter, but of his family he can take care. Okay, now personal and community issues for matter for health. Now what are the things that we have to take care in our society to maintain good health? So as I said, health is a state of physical, mental and social well-being. It cannot be achieved by an individual if one is physically and mentally fit. It depends on surrounding also. So surrounding means public health services are there which maintain this surrounding. So what are the public health services? And because of this public health services, and that's what we say, community hygiene is maintained. Community hygiene is maintained because of these public health services, like removal of garbage, drainage, sewage, then proper drinking water, unadulterated food, vaccination, vector control. So this kind of work is done by this public health services. You have seen municipality comes and lots of functions they do to keep a proper maintained community hygiene of the entire surrounding where you are living. Along with that, you also maintain personal hygiene. So remember, to be disease free, to be healthy also, personal hygiene as well as community hygiene, both the things should be maintained properly. Okay, but what are the conditions that are very very important for this? Like economic condition is one. A proper nutrition is very very essential for good health, as you have seen. But if a person's economic condition is not good, then the proper nutritive food he may not buy, and family cannot afford because of the poor economic condition. So proper training for job, good economic condition needed to maintain the health of the individual. Another one is the social equality and harmony. Now what is the meaning of this? Social equality and harmony. Now, this is a very important factor, social equality and harmony. Required for participating in one another's joy and sorrows. There should not be like misunderstanding between each other. This would make everybody in community happy and healthy. And as I discussed already, the personal hygiene. And this personal hygiene is what? It cleanliness of washing hands, very very important, cleaning of teeth, taking bath regularly, then breathing through nose, regular changing the underwears and garments like socks, handkerchiefs should be changed properly, timely vaccination, protection from vectors, and remaining disease free is these are the aspects of being in good health. Okay, clear? So please read NCRT, why do we fall ill, and join the online class for further discussion. Thank you.